If you want to know why they told you to leave, see what it's like to stay. The Elegant Hotel, Beaumont, Texas. Rita has just checked in. A most unwelcome guest.
All right, we're gonna get out of here. All right, let's go. Whoa!
The relief of morning and the road, if we can find it, to Port Arthur. One of the towns hardest hit by the storm, and along the way there's plenty of evidence that the wrath of nature is random and unreasonable.
Well, as you can see, Rita is still whipping us around 5 hours after the eye of the storm hit this place, and this is the road to Port Arthur, right in the firing line of the hurricane. It's cut off because of flooding. We gather there's extensive damage in the city itself, but at the moment we can't get there.
When the streets aren't rivers, this should be a bustling oil town of 50,000 people. But almost everyone had been evacuated from here. Almost.
What was the damage like in Port Arthur?
Last night, windy, raining, debris, flooding. Thank God I came out of it last night. I was a little bit too late to get up and get away from here. But
Are you scared?
Yeah, I was scared. Yes, I was scared.
An hour later, we saw help arrive. Lots of it. Rita has been less severe than Katrina, but the response to it has been far more swift and efficient. And that is the painful lesson that this country has learnt in recent weeks. Pummeled cities without people, a very eerie sight, but one to get used to. Welcome to the era of mass evacuation. First Louisiana, now Texas. As for the oil refineries that fuel the world's biggest economy, they didn't seem to have been harmed. And slowly the traffic is beginning to return to Houston. Yet in the last 3 weeks, so much has changed. Matt Fry, BBC News, on the Gulf Coast of Texas.